Good evening friends, welcome to my channel. My name is Venkat and I would like to teach you today in this video about an abstract noun. In previous video we have known about kinds of nouns. A noun is mainly divided into a concrete noun and abstract noun. So once again let me remind you about abstract noun, and it is the noun which we can't see, touch, but we feel. And in other words, see here, it refers to the name of a quality, action or state. It tells about a name of a quality and state or else action. So here there are a few examples here. Quality, goodness, honesty, bravery, darkness and sweetness, bitterness, like that we can say many examples. Next one, action. Laughter, movement, joy, hatred, etc. Invite, invitation, arrange, arrangement. Okay, all these are thief, theft. Theft is it comes under action. Like that there are many words or many adjectives that come under this. Next one, third one, state. So in state we have infancy, poverty, slavery, death, etc. Now infancy or already childhood, boyhood, adulthood and youth. So all these are state. They are referred to state. Now, let us try to understand how these abstract nouns are formed. So, these abstract nouns are formed in three ways. Here, from adjectives these are formed, from verbs these are formed, and even from common nouns, abstract nouns are formed. And here there is a note, the names of the arts and subjects are also abstract nouns. Sometimes we have subjects names, so those also come under abstract nouns. Suppose English, mathematics or music, it's a one of art subjects. So music, dance, all these are can be considered as abstract nouns. So now see, from adjectives, happy is an adjective. We can frame abstract noun happiness, like that wise, wisdom. As there is no space here, I have written only two examples, but we can find or we can write many examples for this. For example, we can say beautiful, beauty. Next one, hungry is an adjective, hunger is noun form and abstract noun. In the same manner, angry, anger. So, like this, powerful, power. And difficult, difficulty is the noun form. Okay, like this, we can have, for most of the adjectives, we can have noun form. Then secondly, we can also frame or form abstract nouns from verbs. Suppose, for example, here, act, action, live, life, decide, decision. And a few examples are like this, obey, obedience, arrange, arrangement, invite, invitation. Like this, we can serve many examples, celebrate, celebration, move, movement. Okay, so like this we can say many examples even for action or the verbs which are the words which are formed from verbs. And third one, from common nouns also we can frame abstract nouns. So for example here, slave, slavery. Slave is, it's a common noun, slavery. Friend, friendship. Like this we can we will also have other examples and even child is a common noun. We can have childhood. Okay, like that we have many examples. So it's it doesn't matter whether it comes under quality or action or state, but we need to have that noun form and we need to know how to use in the sentence. But let me tell you one thing, you are not asked in the exam that find out what is its kind, whether it is quality or action or state, but you should know how to use them these in your sentences. So like this, we have abstract noun and we have to practice, and when we read a paragraph in the lesson, we have to underline the verbs and we have to identify adjectives, and sometimes even we have to identify common nouns. Can we find for those words which we have underlined, it might be adjectives or verbs or common nouns, whether we can frame or find an abstract noun, and you can do like that. So next time when you read the lesson or in the lesson or paragraph, just go through the sentences and find out the words and write down the suitable noun form for those words. Suppose if you are reading a paragraph, you came across like a beautiful underline, it's an adjective. Now you write it's a noun form, beauty. So like that, by doing like this, we can develop our skills and our knowledge. Here there is a worksheet. Form noun forms for the given words. First one, great, greatness. Second one, divide, division. Third one, arrive, arrival. Fourth one, believed, belief. Fifth one, advise, advice. So here advice is a verb, advice is a noun. Strong, strength. Appeared, appearance. Young, youth. Owner, ownership. King, kingdom. Famous, fame. Appoint, appointment. Proud, pride. Distribute, distribution. Lazy, laziness. Angry, anger. Able, ability. Danger, dangerous. Danger. Enter, entrance. Admit, admission. So like this, we have noun forms for the verbs and adjectives and even common nouns. So here I'm going to tell you what are the verbs and adjectives and what are the common nouns. So first one, great, is an adjective. Second one, divide, is a verb. Third one, arrive, is a verb. Fourth one, believed, is a verb. Fifth one, advise, is a verb. Sixth one, strong, is an adjective. Seventh one, appear, is a verb. Eighth one, young, is an adjective. Ninth one, owner, is a common noun. Tenth one, king, is a common noun. 11th one, famous, is an adjective. 12th one, appoint, it's a verb. 13th one, proud, it's an adjective. 14th one, distribute, it's a verb. 15th one, lazy, is an adjective. 16th one, angry, is an adjective. 17th one, able, is an adjective. 18th one, dangerous, is an adjective. 19th one, enter, it's a verb. 20th one, admit, again it's a verb. So like this, we have noun forms for the verbs and even for the adjectives. We have rarely for common nouns, but most of the verbs and adjectives, they have noun forms. So if we come across any verb or any adjective or sometimes a common noun, we need to think that is there any noun form for those words, and we can form that noun words. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you very much. Okay. If you like this video, please subscribe it and share it, like it. Thank you very much.